Hello, everybody. My name is Kendra Jones, and I am the district manager for Timberland Regional Library in Washington State. We are just outside of the state's capital. And I'm really happy to have this opportunity to talk to you today about baby story times. I will be giving you some tips specifically about managing the room with babies in it. It's a little bit different than preschool story time and some other events and programs that you might do in the library. So we're just going to talk about a few things that can help you manage that space today. So before we get started, I really want to highlight the importance of having expectations, which I believe you'll be learning about in another video and also, I'm sure, in your coursework with Brooke, because that really can help most issues that might happen in baby story time as long as if you have set those expectations for what caregivers and babies need to be doing or should be how they should be behaving in story time. That will really help mitigate some of that. So the first tip that I have is all about engagement. The more engaged you are with the families that come into your story time, the fewer issues that you're going to have, and the better time everyone's going to be having, honestly. They'll want to come back if you're engaged with them, if you have a relationship with them. So that's not only from the time that they walk into your program, where you're greeting them, you're happy that you're here, you're letting them know what they need to do. Do they need to sit on the floor? Do they need to sit in a chair? Whatever the setup of your program is, you need to let them know what's expected of them. Do you have name tags? I hope that you do. And if you do have name tags, consider giving one to the caregiver and one for the baby so that you can learn everybody's names. That will go a really long way in showing how much you care about the entire family, not just the baby, that you're really there for everybody. So that's the first tip for making sure you can manage that whole crowd with all those babies in it. The next tip is all about safety. So when you are dealing with infants especially, and those ones that are starting to get a little bit mobile, they're kind of fast, you want to make sure that they're really safe and that they can't necessarily get into something that could hurt them. And so whether you're doing it in a meeting room or out in the library, I really encourage you to create what I call the safety circle. So I do this by setting up my room so that there is a circle of about 10 to 15 board books. And they are set up in the middle of the space that you are doing story time. Again, whether it's in, you know, the library, if it's in a meeting room, or maybe you do it at the mall. And there are all kinds of places you could do this story time. Set it up in a circle, and as people come in, you let them know to sit next to a board book. This will create this kind of nice solid circle. And when you get started with story time, you can let everyone know that the reason you set this up this way, so that if those mobile babies get up and start to run or crawl away, we can all help contain them back in the circle so that we make sure they don't, you know, crawl out into the library and get on an elevator or, you know, get lost in the stacks or eat something that they shouldn't. We really want to make sure that they're safe and that all the grown-ups in the room can be relaxed and learn a little bit better in that environment. So another thing that might happen in story times is an older sibling may come. And sometimes that can be a little bit hard to manage because it's an infant story time. And so if everyone else in the room has infants and then one family comes in with, say, a four-year-old, they might be a little nervous about this really big kid being around their very small babies. And so I always want to make it very clear to everybody who comes in that their older siblings, or older children, are absolutely welcome to come to story time. And I just let them know that when they're there, I want them to be extra careful not to step on or accidentally kick or hurt the other babies in any way. Now, caregivers are usually very used to this because they're probably working on the same issues at home because they have a new baby who they're also, you know, concerned with the safety of. So they're already usually working with their older children on how to be gentle with the baby. And you're just really letting them know, really what you're doing is you're letting the other people in the room know that you understand that there could be some anxiety about this. And then the other thing you can do with that older sibling is offer them a stuffed animal or a doll. You could say in future times they're welcome to bring their own stuffed animal or toy, and they can pretend that that stuffed animal is their baby, and they can follow along with all the things that we're doing in story time. And that way they won't get bored, they won't feel like they need to get up and run around, because they'll actually be part of the story time themselves. So those are just three kind of quick tips for helping manage all of the people that come into your story time. You can learn a lot more about baby story time on my blog at klmpeace.wordpress.com. And Brooke has all of my contact information as well. So if you have any follow-up questions, anything else you'd like to discuss, I love talking about baby story time. So please feel free to get in touch and enjoy the rest of your class.